r/AskReddit. What did you think was common knowledge but honestly wasn't? That the moon can be visible in the daytime. Like, how can you go through life never noticing that? Had this conversation with my Mill. My 2-year-old said noon, pointing to the sky, and I translated for him, and Mill says, "Silly boy, the moon is only out at night." His face was priceless. Like he didn't know the words. But he looked at her like, "Okay, but counterpoint, it's right there." I was in the garden with some of my neighbor's kids one summer, and one of them called me over and said, "Look, the moon's out, but the sun's out too. That's cheating." When driving, there's something in between gassing and braking. You can coast to let the car drag and slow a little before turns, exits, to merge into slower traffic. It blows my mind how many people love to ride their brakes, then get right back on the gas and then ride their brakes. I wonder how often they have to change their brakes. Me too. And anyone behind them in traffic seeing the brake lights come on will brake then too. Maybe it's because I drove a stick shift for years that I learned the value of coasting. I've never driven a stick shift. People actually don't realize you can't coast in a car. That blows my mind. That the misuse of antibiotics is a legitimate issue. Had my GF tell me that she never finishes her prescriptions because they give her extras. And then if she's feeling sick in the future, she'll take the extras. Bugs the living shit out of me. My girlfriend does the same thing. If you don't finish antibiotics, you are helping create drug-resistant bacteria. Also, don't go get antibiotics for every stuffy nose you get. A lot of the time, it's just a cold, which is a virus. Antibiotics fight bacterial infections, not viruses. Geography of the world. I was shocked that a lot of people in my campus thought that Singapore was in Europe. Portugal? That's down South America way. Duh, everyone knows it's in China. My brother's middle school teacher refused to believe that Singapore was a separate country and not part of China. Yes, the internet was a thing when this happened. That narwhals are really a thing. My parents thought I had read some fake online article, because in what world would a unicorn whale exist? After a few minutes of looking it up on their own, they realized that these weird creatures are in fact real. I have a twin sister. I'm a guy. You would be surprised how often I get asked if we're identical. No, her dong is bigger. I'm a girl with a twin brother. It feels like every time I tell someone I've just met that I have a twin brother, they ask if we're identical. Very hard not to stare at them in disbelief. The PRNTSCRN button on the keyboard takes a screenshot and loads it into the clipboard. Alt plus PRTSCN will give you only the window in focus. Great for when you don't want the whole screen. That Puerto Rico is part of the United States. Just for comparison, New Mexico license plates used to read New Mexico USA because so many people thought they were not from the US. I live in DC, and every so often there is a news report that some TSA agent or cop in another state claims that a DC driver's license isn't valid. Not surprised. That you have to wash your ass in the shower and put on deodorant every day to keep from smelling like a swamp in the summer. Woo. I was reading the other responses to your comments to check if everyone else has been putting deodorant on their ass and I'm just the abnormal. Then I realized what you meant. It's appalling the number of people who don't actually wash their butthole. Don't flush tampons, or anything that's not toilet paper. I'm looking at you, renters and city folk who came to our Christmas party. Sincerely, homeowner with a septic tank. My dad, contractor, had a client ask him to fix his plumbing. The drains were backing up. Dad goes over there and sees it's not the septic tank being full. He digs a hole and starts looking into the pipes. Starts snaking the pipe. Then in a flood, hundreds of tampon applicators come out of the pipe along with days worth of sludge. I think he was in the hole when that happened and mortified him. Every time he thought about it, he'd tell my sister and I don't put the plastic part of the tampon in the toilet. Started working as a service plumber, and I can't believe how many people are surprised when you say don't put grease down the drain. That's something I grew up with. The mason jar under the sink where you dumped the grease out of the pan. Too many people don't know that it shouldn't go down the drain. Frequently asked questions. Q. What's grease do to my pipes? A. Grease. Fats and oils stick to the sides and solidify. This causes the inside diameter to decrease and leaves behind a sticky uneven surface that stuff can't slide over easily. This is especially bad if you use a garbage disposal. Q. What do I do with the grease if I can't dump it down the drain? A. Trash or a jar. Some people save it for cooking. Some use a jar to prevent their trash from smelling. Some simply dump it outside in the yard. Wipe the pan with a paper towel to further decrease what goes down the drain. Q. What about toilets? A. Shit and shit paper. Nothing else. No wipes. Not even the flushable ones are safe. No tampons. No pads. No diapers. No condoms. Etc. Q. Does hot water help? A. Not nearly as much as you think. Enough hot water will flush out almost anything, and liquid soap can help too, but it's easier and faster to just use a jar or the trash. When I was a kid, I thought when people got hurt, it's normal to get a shot, syringe and needles. Turns out I have hemophilia and my mom was really good at making me not feel like I was different. Damn. As a fellow hemophiliac, my parents had no qualms with letting me know how different my situation was, but they were good at helping me learn that just cause I'm different doesn't mean it's a bad thing or that I should be treated badly for it. Good on your mom though. She sounds like a great parent. Both ways work. It's all in how they execute it in the end. Basic human anatomy. My wife got into it with this lady at work who was in her 50s and insisted that men have one less rib than women because of the Bible story. My mother still thinks this as well actually. I think she's changed her mind since the last discussion about it. Thankfully also I've come across plenty of people think that the stomach is just one large organ that takes up most of the lower abdomen. You just eat food, goes to the stomach, then you poops it out. My wife thought that balls resided directly to the left and right of the penis, like engines on a jet plane. That is a hilarious visual. Was it with you she found out otherwise? Maybe she saw all those middle schoolers' drawings and thought that's what it really looks like. That girls should pee after sex. My roommate just got a UTI and when I asked if she peed after sex, she asked why she would do that. Guys should too. Girls have shorter urethras than guys do, so are more prone to UTIs cause of it. My wife's doc told us that. The dogs chase animals. I see so many people giving away their dogs because they're chasing my chickens. I'm done. They're prey-driven animals. That's literally what most were made to do. OMG, I once watched a show where a woman called in a dog behavior expert because she didn't know what was wrong with her purebred bred small terrier. She keeps chasing rodents. The expert had to explain that that is exactly what this breed is meant for. That there are no tigers in Africa. I was on safari in Tanzania and two others in the truck were discussing how excited they would be to see tigers. I told them there weren't any and they looked all disbelieving and crestfallen. Like I was spoiling their fun. They had to check with the guide. I live in the Midwest around a lot of farmers and country folk. A whole bunch of us went out for a friend's birthday the night before Easter. The bar was playing one of those Charlton Heston movies where he was portraying Jesus. And I made a comment to my boyfriend about how I find it funny that everyone in the movie was white. Considering this story was taking place in the Middle East supposedly 2000 some years ago. One of the guys in our group whipped around like someone just told him a nuclear bomb went off. And was like, what do you mean? Of course Jesus was white. Have you seen all of the paintings in church etc? The long and short of it, I had to explain and show him that different cultures portray Jesus in the skin tone of their choosing, when in reality, if he existed, was probably a pretty dark complected dude. I'm pretty sure I ruined his night. That the word scuba is actually an acronym. Also laser and radar. How mummies were made. Growing up I was obsessed with ancient Egypt and mummies. Even better, my dad worked as a mortician and would casually tell me how the things they did prevented decay etc. I wound up doing a presentation in second grade about the process. I couldn't understand why I got sent to a counselor after that. Funnily enough, I'm now in school for archaeology and going on a dig soon. I'd be pissed if I got a call from the school saying my kid's factual and scientific presentation was inappropriate. I'm glad it didn't stifle your love of learning advanced subjects. Seriously? I read a ton of books when I was a kid that went into excruciating detail about the mummification process. They know kids love that shit. How to use an apostrophe. It's disturbingly common for people to automatically add in an apostrophe when they pluralize a word. That just because someone speaks a different language doesn't mean they are deaf or hard of hearing. Speak slower? Absolutely. Speak 50 decibels louder than normal? Unnecessary. That when you make a Fantastic Four movie, you should try to make it good. That just because you have your turning signal on doesn't mean just go ahead and cut somebody off. Also, it defeats the purpose of using your indicators if you turn them on halfway into changing lanes. It's a huge driving pet peeve of mine. Finland fought and fought hard in World War II. That pound cake is not just a name, but a recipe. Traditionally 1 pound flour, 1 pound sugar, 1 pound butter, 1 pound eggs, plus a dash of vanilla and salt. Was having some convo with a friend about what desserts could be made with just what's in a normal pantry, and I mentioned pound cake, and he asked for the ingredient and the recipe. I had assumed everyone knew pound cake was a recipe, so found this request somewhat odd. He'd never heard of it being a recipe. Started asking other people over the next few days. No one I asked knew about it. Never knew that. But on the other hand, I also don't think I've ever had pound cake. It's really, really good. I mean, there's a pound of butter and a pound of sugar. The difference between there, and there. The difference between its and its. The Holocaust. A friend of mine dated a girl from a small town, and she honestly said she didn't know about it. Polyglottism. In my country, most people speak at least three languages: English, Malay, Mandarin or other Malay dialects, on daily basis. My family and I can speak four languages: English, Malay, Mandarin, Hokkien, fluently. I am also able to speak basic Cantonese, Korean and Tagalog. So, I am confused when people treat my multilingualism as some sort of special intellectual power. I was born and raised in a multilingual society. There is nothing special about my linguistic ability. For those of us raised in a country with one main language, learning a new one can be hard, especially if there's no diversity so you don't get to use the language you're trying to learn. Don't put laundry softener in your towels load. The towels will retain it and be unable to absorb water properly. If you've done this already, you may need to wash your towels several times without softener to get it all out. I have this fight endlessly with my wife. She complains that I leave the towels stiff. Well, you know what, honey? I'd rather be dry and scratchy than dripping wet, caressing myself with an impotent downy cloth. Basic geography. My school never focused on it and I am abysmal at it. I am learning. My kids have a globe and they love to look at the countries. I figure it is good for me too because you are never too old to learn something new. That data is a plural form of datum. That Britain isn't a separate country from England. When I moved to the US, I lost count of the number of people who couldn't understand that I was both English and British. What really ducked with their heads was when I pointed out I was also European. Well, I've seen it on Reddit twice now, and this is where I found out about it, and the first time it blew everyone's mind. Toasters have a tray at the bottom that you can remove to clean the breadcrumbs. New England isn't a state, it's the regroupment of Maine, Vermont, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Rhode Island and Connecticut. Apparently I didn't know that 2 weeks ago. Evolution. I had no idea it could be considered controversial. Happened to mention it to a coworker. Like, he asked about the book I was reading and it was on some biology shit, and among other things I said blah blah about how these evolved to do that. And next thing I know, he's flipping right the duck out on me like, you can't seriously believe that nonsense. And then he bullied me the whole rest of the time I worked there and even recruited a couple easily manipulated, dim-witted druggy youths who worked there to bully me too. You'd think he'd calm down after the first couple hours, you know, or at least by the next day, but nope. He stayed furious forever over me mentioning stuff that's taught from like grade 4 or something onward, and I didn't even suspect that a moment of chit-chat about like ants or something, I forget what book it was, could erupt into any sort of problem. Very startling. Like I opened a can of peanut brittle and snakes popped out. Ha, I just don't get it. Either you accept that the scientific method allows us to figure things out, and experts can inform the rest of us about their field's accumulated knowledge, or you don't. And if you don't accept it, then how can you trust airplanes or heart surgeons or prescriptions or gas appliances or anything else done using science? If you do, then how do you justify trusting, say, the heart surgeon, but not the paleontologist or geologist? I'd met religious folks before, of course, but as far as I knew, they justified discrepancies between scripture and fact. God caused evolution. That passage is a metaphor, etc. Rather than deciding the discrepancies mean fact is not fact. This dude's intense horror at the very idea that someone might trust science was a whole other thing from how normal religious people think. I hope. Ugh, maybe more than I know feel like he does, but they're just smoother and keep it quiet. And there's something bad the incident's done to me. Now I am less likely to trust religious people. Like, I try to avoid telling them anything about me because I am afraid of another freakout, and I don't know what all the things are that they might find triggering. Chickens lay eggs without a rooster being around to breed them. It's weird how many people don't know this. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.